Hello, in this Zotero tutorial, I want to show you what Zotero is capable of doing for your papers. Zotero does all types of citations, MLA, APA, Chicago, and many more. You can add additional citation styles to your Zotero tool and it'll do them as well. It does the parentheticals, the footnotes, and other citations, and it automatically builds your bibliography from a citation library. In this Microsoft Word document, I've already added parenthetical citations with Zotero, but I had to add this in-text citation manually, as you can tell. So you have to type in the in-text citations with the author year and the page number at the end manually. Zotero doesn't do those, but as long as you've cited Aziz elsewhere in your paper, it'll end up in your references. So I want to add another parenthetical citation. And I'm using classic mode here, and then I'll just pick the article, type in the page number, and it adds it in. Now, when I'm done with all my citations, I can add my bibliography. And what's nice about this is you can go back later and add additional citations, and Zotero will adjust your bibliography when you click refresh. So if you want to make any changes to this, you need to edit it in the Zotero library file. Don't correct it here, and then come back and hit refresh, and it will update and correct your bibliography. Zotero works really simply. You just need to do 8 steps to get Zotero working. You need to install Microsoft Word. You cannot be using Word in the cloud. It has to be physically on your computer. OpenOffice, it says it supports that, but we don't recommend it. You'll need Firefox or Chrome. It says it works with Safari. We don't recommend it. It will not work with Edge. Create a free Zotero account at Zotero.org. It's pretty simple. It'll send you an email. Click and verify your email. It doesn't have to be your university account. Then go and download Zotero 5.0 and install it on your computer. You cannot install it on a Chromebook or a tablet, so it has to be an actual Windows or Mac computer. It does say it supports Linux, but I'm not sure about that. Then after you've installed 5.0, install the Zotero connector that works with your browser. Set up your Zotero Sync. Install the Microsoft Word add-in, and then add additional styles. Okay, let's look at that a little more detail. To set up the sync, you go on your computer, on Windows, click Edit Preferences, on a Mac, Zotero Preferences, and then you click Sync. Add your username and password. It should sync and you should get a green light. If you don't, check your account as you previously created it. To install the Microsoft Word add-in, it's a little tricky. Again, you have to have Microsoft Word installed on your computer. It can't be in the cloud. Open Zotero on your computer and click Edit Preferences or Zotero Preferences. Click Cite, Word Processors, and we highly recommend you use Classic dialog box. It's just so much easier. Then install the Word add-in. It may say reinstall. Either way, it's the same thing. I find sometimes you have to install it and reinstall it a couple of times and restart Word and repeat, and finally it shows up. So just do it and then turn it off and try on until you see the Zotero plugins in Microsoft Word as previously demonstrated. You can add additional citation styles if you need to. Go to your computer, click Edit Preferences or Zotero Preferences, click Cite, and then get additional styles. They're a little tricky. Turabian's there, you'll have to add it. Some of the older styles are showing up in Zotero, so it takes a little bit for them to get the latest, newest citation style. You may notice a lag, maybe as much as a year or more, because some of the citation styles have recently changed. So it is a free tool. Still, it's great. If you have to use an old style, just be familiar with the style manual and you can correct those minor changes yourself. The Zotero library is really easy to use. You're just going to create that on your computer. It's great because it saves everything in the cloud. When you're in a database, you'll click the little yellow folder and that will save a whole bunch of items into your Zotero library. You can just choose the ones you want and it'll add them all to your library. If you see a single icon like a little paper, that means it found an article and it will save it as an article. And when you click it, it will add it to your Zotero library with the PDF if it can access the full text. It'll pull the PDF in. You can add it manually later yourself. If you see a little book icon, that means Zotero thinks you're looking at a book. It does web pages, articles, books. It sees different things. It's really clever. The most important thing is after you've pulled something from a database into the Zotero library, you need to check the library. If you fail to check the library, Zotero is going to work poorly for you and the citations will not be accurate in your research paper. So check the title, make sure the capitalization is correct. You can see some capitalization errors in this title for APA. Then check your author, the date. Sometimes I have to make the date just the year. You may need to add the DOI. You can manually create these or edit these as you see fit. If you see a problem in your paper, come back and edit in the library. Don't edit in your paper. If you want to add an attachment, you can add a PDF directly to a Zotero record. And what's really clever is the Zotero library is in the cloud, so you're permanently saving your citation and your PDF of the document. And that way, if anything happens, you have a copy in the cloud, and when you resync Zotero on your computer, you'll get all those things back. I recommend that you visit the library.su.edu/Zotero site, where there's more details on setting up and configuring Zotero and some extra features Zotero can do. If you need help, please contact the library and ask me for assistance, and we'll assist you. Have a great day.